Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. This video describes the discovery of BLU-945. This compound is an EGFR inhibitor and is in development for the treatment of lung cancer in patients who are no longer responding to their current therapy. The video reports the discovery program of BLU-945 as described in a Drug Annotations article in the Journal of Medicinal Chemistry by scientists at Blueprint Medicines in Cambridge, Massachusetts. The citation is at the bottom of the screen, and a link to the article can be found in the video description. This video is not a complete description of the article. I have selected the parts I consider to be the research highlights that best summarize the project. I am also emphasizing the details that mesh well with the topics I teach in my medicinal chemistry and drug discovery classes. Let's open with the unmet medical need that is being addressed by this drug program: lung cancer. Lung cancer is responsible for 18% of all cancer deaths. In particular, non-small cell lung cancer, NSCLC, accounts for 80 to 85% of those deaths. A large fraction of non-small cell lung cancers are linked to mutations in the epidermal growth factor receptor, EGFR. Two key mutations are deletions in exon 19 and of the EGFR gene, and a single mutation, leucine 858 to arginine in exon 21. If a patient is found to have NSCLC and a tumor biopsy reveals one of these two mutations via genetic typing, then the patient is said to have EGFR-positive lung cancer. Patients with EGFR-positive tumors are treated with tyrosine kinase inhibitors, TKIs. Were this slide the end of the story, then the unmet medical need would be much less significant. Unfortunately, this slide is not the end of the story. Tumor cells in non-small cell lung cancer patients being treated with TKIs can undergo additional mutations. Two notable mutations are threonine 790 to methionine and cysteine 797 to serine. Typically, the T790M mutation is observed first, with the C797S mutation following afterwards. These mutations confer resistance to the tumor against current TKI drugs. And at the time of this video, there is no single therapy for EGFR plus tumors that carry both mutations. We have now outlined the goal for this drug discovery program at Blueprint Medicines. The goal is to design a new TKI with activity against EGFR plus tumors with one or both of these mutations. These mutated forms of EGFR are our drug target for this program. Equally important to efficacy against EGFR plus tumor cells, the compound also needs to have low activity against non-mutated EGFR, wild-type EGFR. The patient's healthy cells have wild-type EGFR, and inhibition of wild-type EGFR will show high toxicity and pose a potential safety risk. Before we start looking at active compounds, let's list some key abbreviations. So WT is for wild type, specifically wild type EGFR. LR refers to the L858R mutation in exon 21. This is one of the situations that gives rise to the EGFR positive tumors. X19 refers to exon 19 deletions, which is another situation that gives rise to EGFR plus tumors. Note, saying a tumor is EGFR positive is a bit ambiguous, as multiple conditions can give rise to an EGFR plus tumor. TM is a specific mutation observed in EGFR plus tumors of patients who have received TKI treatment. CS is another observed mutation. At last, here are some TKIs that have been researched for non-small cell lung cancer. So, this problem of TKI resistance is not a completely new problem, and the article mentions efforts that other researchers have made in this area. The authors mention several. I'm highlighting three for various reasons. On the left is a compound that has been researched in combination with an antibody treatment to address both common mutations in EGFR-positive tumors. On an earlier slide, I mentioned that there is no single treatment for this purpose. That is true. This is specifically a combo therapy, a combination of the small molecule drug and antibody. I will note that this molecule contains a phosphine oxide, which is not a functional group that I have ever seen in a molecule advanced into the clinic. So that is a bit interesting to me as a chemist. The two compounds on the right both address TM resistance. In the top compound, I want to highlight this substituted four-membered ring with a nitrogen, an azetidine. In the bottom compound, I want to focus on this six-membered ring with a nitrogen, a piperidine with the OH and fluoro groups. Both of these features, the substituted azetidine and piperidine, will reappear in later compounds. This kind of thing happens all the time in drug discovery. Later researchers take inspiration from previous research in creating new, more optimized compounds. The scientists at Blueprint started their program with a screening campaign. Blueprint has an in-house library with over 25,000 kinase inhibitors. Compound 4 is one of the promising hits from the screen. It has decent potency against both the single and double mutant EGFR+, specifically the LR form of EGFR+. Compound 4 shows essentially no activity against wild-type EGFR. All of these are biochemical assays, in vitro assays. In early SAR in this hit series, the chemist took a cue from previous research and incorporated the fluorohydroxy piperidine system that we mentioned on the previous slide, with a nice bump in potency in compound 5. Finally, the chemist incorporated another ring to give compound 6, again with a boost in potency, and still no observable activity against wild-type EGFR. Across these three compounds, metabolic stability assays involving human liver microsomes indicated increasing intrinsic clearance, which can decrease both bioavailability and half-life. So metabolic stability must be monitored as the compound advances. Note that the assays on this slide give early insight into the potency and efficacy of the compounds, on-target activity, safety in the form of off-target activity on the wild-type receptor, and possible insight into pharmacokinetics through metabolic stability. Moving forward, the scientists focused on the N-methyl substituent in the upper left of compound 6. The structure on the right is not compound 6, but it's very close. It has an extra methyl group on the piperidine ring. This series of compounds varies the R group on the main ring system. Incorporation of rings in place of the N-methyl did not help potency until substituents were placed on the four-membered ring, as substituted azetidine. If that seems familiar, we saw a substituted azetidine in one of the literature compounds from a couple slides ago. Compound 24 shows outstanding potency. While we're starting to see activity on wild-type EGFR, there is still a 10,000-fold difference between these two activities. Intrinsic clearance based on human liver microsomal data is also reasonable. I'm only showing the results of these few compounds and assays, but the paper has nearly 20 compounds in this series and a number of additional assays, including some cellular activity assays, not just biochemical assays. That would be Table 2 in the paper if you are interested. The scientists were able to obtain a co-crystal between compound 24 and EGFR LRTM. The PDB entry is 8D76. Here is the landing page for the co-crystal. Let's now look at the co-crystal. Before we do so, I want to highlight this sulfone group as well as the fluoro and hydroxy groups on the piperidine ring. We'll see all these groups prominently in the X-ray structure. Here is our structure in the binding pocket. We can zoom in some. There's our molecule, that is compound 24, and here is a receptor around it. Let's change the view. We're going to go to a ligand view, which will isolate and take away some of the extraneous details. And here is our molecule. You can see it sits pretty flat in the binding pocket over on this side. So here is our azetidine, our four-membered ring with the nitrogen, and off of it we have this sulfone, and this sulfone is picking up some key hydrogen bonding interactions to amino acids in the receptor. There are a number of other interactions. These are these dotted lines to and from the receptor and compound 24. And then I want to go over to this fluorine and oxygen. And here is, let's get a better view. Here's our six-membered ring. This is the piperidine. And this green atom is the fluorine. And it has some hydrophobic contact interactions with the backbone. And then the OH off of our piperidine ring, the hydroxy group, is interacting with a protonated lysine atom. So we're seeing some hydrogen bonding interactions there, and that just gives you a feel for how compound 24 fits within the binding pocket for this receptor. Compound 24 was studied for its PK properties in rats and revealed a very low bioavailability of just 2%. The low bioavailability of 24 is likely caused by its high clearance, as well as a high efflux ratio observed in permeability assays. Removal of one of the ring nitrogens gave compound 26. Now with reduced polar surface area, improved passive permeability, and diminished efflux ratio, clearance was also reduced, and compound 26 had a much improved bioavailability. Addition of a methyl group on the azetidine ring to give 27 did not have a great impact on PK, but did improve selectivity over wild-type EGFR. Compound 27 therefore had promising PK in the rat and predicted PK in the monkey. NHP, non-human primate, was also promising based on in vitro data. Unfortunately, compound 27 showed high clearance in vivo. This is a case of the in vitro studies not correlating well with the observed in vivo results. The poor in vitro, in vivo correlation, IVIVC, was attributed to the in vitro studies relying on liver microsome stability assays. Microsomal assays are effective for understanding phase 1 metabolic reactions, but less so for phase 2 conjugations, which require stability data from hepatocytes, not just microsomes. As it turns out, the OH group on 27 undergoes fairly rapid clearance through glucuronidation, a phase 2 reaction. The MedChem group performed a number of modifications around the alcohol, adding small alkyl groups and introducing one or more additional fluoro groups around the ring. In the end, the best solution was capping the alcohol as a methyl ether to give compound 30. Compound 30 showed much reduced glucuronidation. Other compounds were explored, but compound 30 had the best balance of potency, efficacy, PK, and selectivity. This slide summarizes some of the key properties. Compound 30's activity on wild-type EGFR is very weak. Potency for both EGFR plus forms, whether LR or X19, is higher, but not remarkably so. Once EGFR plus has additional mutations, the potency of 30 improves to sub-nanomolar levels. This activity matches the goal of the drug program to design a molecule with high potency for the mutations of EGFR+. PK properties in NHP are shown on the right. The half-life is reasonable at 3.5 hours. The predicted human half-life is 6 to 7 hours based on hepatocyte data, not just microsomal data. In vivo efficacy studies involved a mouse xenograft disease model. The study looked at changes in tumor volume over a two-week treatment period. Tumors with both EGFR plus variations, L858R in exon 19 and exon 19 deletions with additional mutations were studied. Note that the numbers in this table were read off a graph in the paper, and the values are approximate. Vehicle groups showed rapid growth of the tumors from a starting volume of 100 cubic millimeters. Animals treated with a TKI, osimertinib, which is not effective against advanced mutations, showed similar growth. Higher doses of compound 30 not only prevented tumor growth, but also caused reduction in tumor size. Based on these promising results, compound 30 advanced for further study. So compound 30, which has a drug candidate compound number, BLU-945, has completed preclinical tox studies to enable clinical trials. A phase 1, phase 2 study in non-small cell lung cancer patients is currently in progress at the time of the creation of this video. Early data from a 25 milligram starting dose shows that BLU-945 has low clearance and a long half-life. The clinicaltrials.gov identifier for the trial is on the screen. Thank you so much for watching to the end of this drug discovery story on BLU-945. A link to the original JMedChem article is in the video description. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.